Hello my dear students, today we are going to start lesson number 1 in social science and the name of the lesson is Heritage of India. So let's begin. India is a land of ancient culture. Ancient Indian scripture Vishnu Puran states
Uttara yat samudrasya himadrishchev dakshinam varshatad bharat nam bharti yatra Sansatiham.
It means that in the north we have the Himalayas, which surround the northern boundaries of our country, and in the opposite direction, that is the south, we have the ocean. So we have beautiful boundaries across all the four sides of our country. It is said that new descendants are called Indians. Now, what is meant by descendants? Descendants means the successor or heir. So, the new successor or descendants are called Indians. In the beginning of any auspicious ceremony, Bharat Varsha, Bharat Khanda, Jambudvip and Aryavarta etc. words are used while taking resolution. So, resolution means taking any decision. So these words like Bharat Varsha, Bharat Khanda, Jambudvip and Aryavarta, these words are used on auspicious ceremony, okay, while taking any important decision, okay. So these are the words that are used. Our country is gifted with the natural boundaries Himalaya in the north and sea in the east, west and south. So we saw in the first line also that in the north side of our country has the beautiful boundaries of Himalayas, and in the east, west and the south we have the sea. From all over the world, different countries mesmerized by the Indian prosperity and came to trade, settled and mingled with the Indian culture. So in the previous standard we have studied that how different countries of the world came to India by seeing its prosperity, because we had ample of resources. So they came for trading purpose and they mingled and settled over here, okay, for long period, and they started ruling us, okay. So this is how the exchange of culture happened. Due to mutual exchange, many changes have been seen in our culture. In this way, our heritage is transformed from generation to generation and it is continuously progressing. So even till today, you will find many places of our country who have exchanged the culture with the other countries of the world, who came and settled in our country for a long period, okay. So those places are like Goa and Pondicherry. You will find the culture of Portuguese culture over there till now, okay. So this is how the heritage transfer from generation to generation and it is continuously progressing. India, location and area. We have already studied in standard 9th about the present area and location of India. It was very vast in ancient time, and now area-wise it stands on the 7th rank and population-wise on the 2nd. So area-wise India ranks 7th and population-wise 2nd largest country in the world. Which is the first largest country? It is China. So after China, India ranks 2nd for population. Next is rich and varied heritage. Our motherland has bestowed rich and varied heritage to us as to the world. Indian culture have been trade oriented and peace loving. So bestowed means gifted, okay. So our motherland is gifted with variety of heritage compared to the other part of the world. So as we saw earlier also in the above paragraph, our country is divided with the natural boundaries on the north with Himalayan mountains, okay, and on the east, west and south side it is surrounded by the sea, which is very beneficial for trade purpose. Also our country was always peace loving country. It always believed in maintaining peace. Sat, Chit and Anand are realized from Indian culture. Sat means truth, Chit means
consciousness, and anand means joy. So all this sat chit and anand are realized from the Indian culture. Means we Indians always believe in sat chit and anand. Beside this, Indian culture prospered with the mutual exchange of different cultures of other countries which came to India and settled here. They have accepted the values of non-violence and peace which have been adopted and admired by the world. So we all know that the Britishers, Portuguese, then Dutch, the French, so many people from so many countries came to our country and they ruled us, okay? So obviously when people from different culture will stay together, they will definitely exchange some or the other thing, whether it is culture, habits or anything. So this is how our culture and their culture was exchanged as they settled here for some time, right? And they also accepted the value of non-violence and the importance of peace, which was adopted and admired by the whole country. And this was whose culture? It was Indian culture. People right from the beginning of Indus Valley civilization till today have made our country rich and wealthy with their intellectual ability, talent and skill. So we all know how developed the people of Indus Valley civilization were, right? They had developed such advanced city at that time only, okay? So people from the beginning of Indus Valley civilization till today have contributed and they have made our country rich and wealthy by using their intellectual, means their intelligence, their ability, their skill and their talent. Innumerable scholars, thinkers, artisans, sages, saints, scientists and historians have contributed to the growth and development of our culture. So there are so many people who have contributed towards the development of our culture, like scholars, thinkers, scientists, historians, saints, sages and so many people. Okay, they have added their thoughts and their values which have developed our culture and has increased the value of our culture, right? Culture is sum of habit, values, custom, tradition and conduct of lifestyle of human. When we say culture means it is a mixture or combination of values, custom, tradition and conduct of lifestyle. Means each country has its own culture, obviously, because people of different countries have different habits, values, custom, tradition, right? So the culture also varies from country to country, okay? So that is why we can say culture is sum of habits, values, custom and tradition and conduct of lifestyle of human. Now let's see what is meant by culture. Meaning of culture. Culture means a way of life. It is made of changes that occurs in public life, social rules and regulation of different societies. It can be said that culture is total of habits, values, customs, traditions and idea leading humans to the highest level. So culture means the way we live. Our lifestyle can say a lot about our culture. Okay, our habits, values and custom and tradition, our ideas, our thoughts, all these are included in culture. Now when we talk about culture, it means we have certain types of habits. Different family follow different kind of habit. They have different values. Okay, so it differs from families to families. But we are a social animal, right? We human beings are social animal. So we have to follow certain customs and tradition when we live in a society. So when we talk about culture from individual point of view, we can say culture means total of habits and values. But in a society, we have to follow certain rules and regulation. Okay, it differs from society to society, from country to country. So when we talk about culture from the society point of view, we have to say that culture means the sum of custom and tradition and ideas that leads human to the highest level. Next, cultural heritage of India. Heritage means a valuable gift from our forefathers to us.
Indian history is thousands of years old. We say in school pledge, I love my country and I am proud of its rich and varied heritage. In this context, heritage is precious gift from our motherland to the whole world. About mysteries of human life, we divide our culture into two divisions. So heritage means whatever valuable gift we get from our forefather, that is known as heritage. That is, we can also say inheritance. Okay. Basically, heritage is divided into two parts. The first is cultural heritage and the second is natural heritage. Okay. And in natural heritage, man has not played any role in its development. It is all nature based. And in cultural heritage is completely based on man-made things. Okay. So now we are going to study about the natural heritage of India. It is divided into four parts. The first is landscape, second is river, third is vegetation, and the fourth is wildlife. So let's begin. First, we are going to study about the natural heritage of India. So let's start. The result of close relationship between nature, environment, and human life is natural heritage. So what is natural heritage? It means close relation between nature, environment, and human life. How close we are to nature, that is known as natural heritage. So that is what we are going to learn in this topic. So let's start. Natural heritage of India is unique and varied. It includes features like, now we are going to see what are the things that are included in nature. So you can imagine whatever comes to your mind, that whatever is present on the earth, naturally that is included in natural heritage. Okay, so let's see. Mountains, forests, deserts, rivers, streams, seas, trees, plants, creepers, flowers, leaves, insects, and varied landscapes, wide range of minerals, vegetation, plants, and animals. So all these things are natural things. So they are natural heritage. Okay, let's move on. We are the children of nature, so it has made a beautiful arrangement for our food, water, fresh air, and dwelling to cater our all needs. So whatever we have today is because of nature. We get food, fresh water, fresh air, and we have a place to dwell. We have a place to live, and that is all because of nature. Even if we have the infrastructural facilities and we have new technologies, but nature is a basic thing without which we cannot do, right? So a beautiful arrangement is made by nature, which helps us to satisfy our need, our basic needs like food, water, shelter, right? So it helps to satisfy our all needs, correct? Next, we treat nature with respect and faith. The example of our close relation with nature are stories of Panchatantra and Jhatka tales of Buddhist religion. So in the stories of Jhatka tales, Gautam Buddha appeared as human being also and as animal also. Okay, so both the Panchatantra and Jhatka tales tells the story that how we can overcome the difficult situation in life, and these are related to nature. Okay, so this is considered to be the best example because it shows the close relation between nature and human beings. Okay, then our cultural and folk music and several ragas are based on prahars. Prahar means a period of day. Okay, and prahar is divided into 8 parts, and one prahar consists of 3 hours. Okay, so there are 4 prahars in day and 4 prahars at night. Okay, so in total there are 8 prahars. Okay, similarly, Ayurveda, Yunani, and nature cure are totally based on nature. So we all know Ayurveda. What is meant by Ayurveda? It is completely based on nature. In the same manner, Yunani is also totally based on nature. It is a traditional method of making medicine. Okay, and it is usually found in Muslim culture and it is practiced in South Asia. Okay, next is landscape.
Beautiful landscapes are generally formed due to different shapes of land. For example, the Himalaya is a landscape. It has endowed Indians abundantly with useful vegetation and minerals. In our country, we have desert, then plains, then mountains, and different kind of landscape. Okay, so this has given us, it is like a gift from the nature, which is useful as a vegetation, and it provides us vegetation and minerals also. Then strange birds, animals, and mountain peaks covered with snow, brimming rivers are gift of Himalayas. So on Himalaya, there are different kinds of birds, animals, there is mountain peaks which are covered with snow, and there is brimming river, means overflowing river, which is a gift of Himalaya to us. Now it is not very easy to find a country where there is desert, there is a region where it snows, there are coastal regions and there are peninsulas. So India is gifted by nature, so it is our natural heritage. Forest of Terai and its pilgrimage places, for example, Amarnath, Badrinath, Kedarnath, and summit like Nanda Devi are in Himalayas. So there are so many pilgrimage places where we can visit. There are which are on the top of the mountains, and there are summits. Summit means high peak. So such kind of mountains are also present in Himalayas. Since ancient time, Himalayas has great importance for India. So from the very ancient time only, we Indians have given more importance to Himalayas, from the religious point of view also, and from natural point of natural heritage point of view also. Next is rivers. Rivers have been providing natural way since ancient time. Indian culture has flourished on the river bank of Indus and the Ravi. So it is said that the Indian culture is flourished, means developed, on the bank of river Indus and the river Ravi. The rivers like the Ganga, the Yamuna, the Saraswati, the Indus, the Narmada, the Godavari, and the Krishna, etc., have profoundly influenced the people of India. So all these rivers have definitely influenced, means have given great impact on the life of people of India. Rivers are the source of drinking water, domestic use, irrigation, electricity, and waterways. So river is a source of water which helps us in fulfilling our day-to-day requirement. Beside this, man was dependent on river to develop industries of clay utensils, plastering and building of houses. So apart from fulfilling the basic needs, there are some other needs also. So man started developing the industries near the river banks so that they could get the water easily for making clay utensils, then plastering, and for building of houses. Okay. Then river water has made human life beautiful and prosperous. Landscape scenes at dawn and dusk are very fascinating on the side of river. These are sources of inspiration for artists and have enriched the life of the people by developing the aesthetic scenes. So river water has made our life more beautiful and meaningful. It has given prosperity to our life. Okay, so the landscape scene of dusk and dawn. Dusk and dawn means the sunset and the sunrise. It looks so beautiful and fascinating at the riverside. So this beautiful sceneries give inspiration to the artist to make paintings, which enriches and gives a meaning to our life, right? So this aesthetic scenes, means the attractive scenes, helps the artisans to develop their skills and their paintings, which adds beauty to our life. Next is vegetation. People of India are environment lover since ancient time. Its proof is their love and affection towards flowers and shrubs and plants. The best example I can give you is of Tulsi, which is a shrub, and you can find this shrub in every house of Hindu. It is also worshipped and it is also used as a medicine. Okay, then humans, animals, birds, etc. are dependent on tree for their food. So even human beings, along with animals and birds, we all are dependent on tree for our food. Okay, banyans and peepal tree and basil are worshipped in India. So there are different kind of vrats in which the Hindu people go to the trees of banyan people and tulsi, and they worship them. So this is how important the vegetations are to us. Cereals, pulses, oil seed plant, green field, prosperous herbs packed forest, and medical plants have ultra enriched our life from ancient time only. So there are various herbs which acts as a medicine. Okay, it acts as a herbal medicine for us. Harade, amla, bahenda, aloe vera, adusi, neem, etc. medicine. These are all the herbal herbs and shrubs which are used as medicine. Flowers like rose, lotus, mogra, damora, sunflower, champa, juhi, jasmine, etc. have made human life beautiful, fragrant, healthy and prosperous. Thus, social and religious life of India is greatly influenced by vegetation. Now, how these flowers have influenced our social and religious life? It is because we offer this beautiful, fragrant and prosperous flowers to God. We offer flowers to God, and also we use flowers in any kind of ceremony. Okay, so this is how flowers have made our social and religious life beautiful and prosperous also. Next is wildlife. India is a nature lover since ancient time. It is a country with animal lover culture. Lion, tiger, elephant, rhino, foxes, bear, deer, sambar, rabbit, python, snake, mongoose, lizard, porcupine, like many such organisms are found and seen in India. So all these animals are found in our country, and from the ancient time only our country is considered to be animal lover. A culture is known as the culture of animal lover, and India is a nature lover since ancient time. Then, Asian lion in the world are found only in Gir forest of Gujarat. A religious belief has given a status of god and god goddesses vehicle to some of the wild animals, tiger, peacock, alligator, eagle, etc. So we have considered these animals as a vehicle of God and goddesses also. Like tiger, peacock, alligator, these are the animals, wild animals, which are considered as a vehicle of God. Our country is highly valued by having figure of four lion, horse, elephant and bull. Furthermore, to protect the wildlife reserve are created, and even laws for the protection of their life have been enacted. So even on our national currency, to give the animals more value, figure of lions, four lions, horses, elephant and bull are presented over there. And even to protect the wildlife, reserves are created so that we can protect them and save their lives. Also, various laws are made to protect the wildlife animal. So in this topic, we have studied about the natural heritage of India. So natural heritage exists naturally. Man has played no role in its existence. Okay. So natural resources are divided into four parts: landscape, river, vegetation and wildlife. Now we are going to study about the cultural heritage of India. Cultural heritage of India. India has gifted to the world a diverse and rich heritage. Cultural heritage is man-made heritage. Whatever is received or created by human with his tact, wisdom, art and skill is called cultural heritage. So we can say that India has gifted to the world different and variety of heritage, which is very rich. Now we can say that cultural heritage is man-made, completely man-made, and the nature has played no role in its existence. Okay, so whatever is received or created by human being with his tact means his understanding, his wisdom, then art and skill, and according to his talent, whatever he has made using all these things, that is known as cultural heritage. starting from Aryans, Kshatrap, Kushan, Huns, Persian, Turks, Arabs, Mughals, Britishers, French, etc. Caste and tribes have come to India. Indian culture from the exchange between all this has become rich. Okay, so there are different there came different type of people from different kind of country. They settled in India, and this is how we exchanged culture with them, and that made our culture more rich. The people of India from the prehistoric period have contributed to the people of the world. The art of architecture and sculpture are 5,000 years old. So the talent, the art which we have in our country is how many years old? It is 5,000 years old. And whatever sculptures and architect we can see today is 5,000 years old. The remains of the Indus Valley civilization is an evidence of this. So Indus Valley civilization people were very advanced. They were very developed. They had advanced city at that time only. Okay. On seeing the remains of the figure of god and goddesses, humans, animals and several toys, as well as sculpture of bearded man and the statue of dancer, one feels self-esteem and pride in our cultural heritage. If we see the statues of the god and goddesses, then humans, animals and all this, and also the sculpture of the bearded man and the statue of the dancer, we will feel self-esteem, means we will feel the self-respect, and we will feel proud of our cultural heritage because it is so beautifully sculpted, even at that time also when they didn't had any kind of technology. Further, when we look at the figure of bullock or lion on an inverted lotus of Mayuran era, so there is an figure of bullock and lion on inverted lotus, okay, of Mayuran era of that time. The statue of Gautam Buddha in meditative form. Then the Kalkan statue of Jain Shankar, the caves of Ellora of Rashtrakuta dynasty, etc. So if we see the Kalkan statue of Jain Tirthankar, the Jain Tirthankar was a spiritual teacher of Jainism religion. Okay, so the caves of Ellora of Rashtrakuta dynasty, etc. By seeing this heritage, we feel proud, glad and also respect for our cultural heritage. So if we look at these beautiful sculptures and architect, we will definitely feel proud. Now let's see what our cultural heritage actually consists of. Okay, so our cultural heritage accommodates palaces, buildings, sculptures, stupas, viharas, chaityas, temples, mosques, tombs, forts and gates. So all these things are all this comes under cultural heritage. Even historical places of our freedom movement like Sabarmati Ashram, Dandi, Bardoli, Vardha, Shantiniketan, Delhi, etc. Can also be considered as a part of our cultural heritage, because many great historical events took place at these places. So we can consider these places also as our part of cultural heritage. Besides languages, script, discovery of zero, mathematics, calendar, astronomy, iron, literature, religion, Yuddha Shastra, chariot, political science, zoology, botany, Vastu Shastra, religion, republic, judiciary, legislation, environment protection, etc. are important discoveries of India. So all these things are discovered in India itself. So this can also be considered as our part of cultural heritage. Now let's study about the cultural heritage of Gujarat. Previously we studied about the cultural heritage of India. Now we are going to study specifically about Gujarat. Okay, heritage of Gujarat. So in this, you just have to remember everything there, because there is nothing to explain in this. Okay, so let's start. The places having cultural, legendary and archaeological importance are Lothal, Rangpur, Dholavera, Rozadi or Srinathgarh, etc. The places of pilgrimage are Victory Tower of Vadnagar, stone inscription of King of Ashoka at Junagadh, Sun Temple of Modera, Gate of Champaner, Rudra Mahalaya of Sidhpur, मंसर लेक ऑफ विराम गाम, जामा मस्जिद ऑफ अहमदाबाद, झूलता मीनार विच इज़ ऑल्सो नोन एज द शेकिंग टार्स, सिद्दी सैयद नी जाली दैट इज़ ऑल्सो सिद्दी सैयद ग्री, ओके, द टेम्पल ऑफ हाथी सिंह, सहस्त्रलिंगा ऑफ पाटन, राजमहल ऑफ वडोदरा, टूम्ब ऑफ मोहब्बत खान, पारसी अग्यारी ऑफ नवसारी आर वर्थ सीइंग प्लेस. सो दीज आर द थिंग्स यू हैव प्लेसेस यू हैव टू रिमेंबर बिकॉज इफ क्वेश्चन इज आस्क अबाउट द कल्चरल हेरिटेज ऑफ गुजरात यू हैव टू राइट द नेम ऑफ ऑल दीज प्लेसेस. एंड प्लेसेस हैविंग रिलीजियस इंपॉर्टेंस आर द्वारकाधीश टेम्पल ऑफ द्वारका, शारदा पीठ ऑफ जगतगुरु शंकराचार्य, सोमनाथ टेम्पल वन ऑफ द 12 ज्योतिर्लिंगा, अंबाजी इन नॉर्थ गुजरात विच इज सिचुएटेड इन बनासकांठा डिस्ट्रिक्ट, बहुचा राजी महसाना डिस्ट्रिक्ट, रणछोड़ ड्राई टेम्पल डाकोरा केडा डिस्ट्रिक्ट एंड शामलाजी अरावली डिस्ट्रिक्ट. ओके, सो यू हैव टू मेमोराइज ऑल दिस प्लेसेस ऑफ रिलीजियस इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑल्सो. देन वेल नोन रिलीजियस सोशल एंड टूरिज्म ओरिएंटेड प्लेसेस इन गुजरात आर पोलो फॉरेस्ट, विजयनगर काइट फेस्टिवल, कांकरिया कार्निवल, ताना रीरी फेस्टिवल, नॉर्दर्न डांस फेस्टिवल, रणोत्सव इन कच्छ एक्सेट्रा. ओके, सो दीज आर द नेम्स ऑफ द फेमस फेस्टिवल्स एंड टूरिज्म ओरिएंटेड प्लेसेस इन गुजरात विच यू हैव टू मेमोराइज. टूरिस्ट प्लेस ऑफ जैन एंड बुद्धिस्ट. जैन एंड बुद्धिस्ट रिलीजन प्रिवेल इन इंडिया, कॉन्सिक्वेंटली जैन एंड बुद्धिस्ट केव्स आर सीन एट वेरियस प्लेसेस इन गुजरात, वडनगर, तारंगा, खांबलिया, सामलाजी, कोटेश्वर, तालाजा, डांग, जागडिया एक्सेट्रा. सो हियर ऑन ऑल दिस प्लेसेस वी विल फाइंड द केव्स ऑफ बुद्धिस्ट एंड जैनिज्म. ओके, देन I want you all to go through this table. It is the list of fairs of Gujarat. In this, name of the fair, place of the fair and the time of fair is mentioned. Okay, so there is no need of any kind of explanation. So just go through it and memorize it as it can be asked in the form of MCQ also.